There have been some comments that we have reduced the testing of migrant workers, leading to a drop in the number of COVID-19 confirmed cases. Let me say that this is not true. Our testing capacity for migrant workers is about 3,000 a day. We have not reduced it. Instead, we have been increasing the capacity of testing of our migrant workers. The rate of testing has not slowed down. A total of 21,000 migrant workers living in dormitories have been tested since the start of the outbreak. This means that 1 in 15 migrant workers in dormitories have been tested. This is far higher than the testing rates seen in other countries like Korea, which is 1 in 90, as well as other countries like US, UK, or even Hong Kong. We have started our testing with the dormitories where there were a high number of cases detected, and now we are actively testing the other dormitories as cases emerge, including the factory-converted dormitories. With this testing approach to determine the extent of infection in the dormitories, the case count from the dormitories will depend to a large extent whether there is a high prevalence rate in these dormitories. But every positive test is added to our daily count. Some of the migrant workers continue to work as they are essential workers. Therefore, to reduce the risk of transmission in workplaces and the wider community, we have also prioritized the testing of migrant workers in essential services during this period. We are also actively testing around confirmed cases in these dormitories where new cases are starting to emerge in an effort to isolate cases and contain further transmission to prevent these dormitories to have many, many clusters evolving. For dormitories where the assessed rate of infection is extremely high, our efforts are focused on isolating those who are symptomatic, even without a confirmed COVID-19 test. This allows us to quickly provide medical care to these patients.